All right, so it's time for our Q&A about the new Captain America shield. So one of the most common questions I saw on both the videos is, how heavy is it? And honestly, I don't actually know. So let's find out. Got a little scale here. All right, 14.26 kilograms, or just over 30 pounds. So yeah, these are pretty heavy. It would be really cool to make one out of titanium because we could basically halve the weight. It would only weigh about 15 and a half pounds then. But unfortunately, titanium, well, I'm not very good at TIG welding yet, and titanium is pretty expensive, but maybe sometime in the future, we'll try remaking this out of titanium, which would be really cool. Another common question was asking about how long did it actually take to make? Because the funny thing with videos is you can make it look a lot more simple than it really is. So for this project, it actually took about 2 weeks of design on the computer just to design it before we even start building it. Now that did include a bit of the MDF, the cardboard prototype that I made using the laser cutter. And then building it, I think that was about a good solid 3 weeks with almost four people working full time. So this was actually a very extensive project and a very expensive one too, just considering the man hours that went into it. So with that in mind, how much did it actually cost to make? Well, again, it wasn't cheap. The most expensive cost was actually the labor that went into it, because like I said, multiple weeks of full-time labor. But that being said, even the components alone were pretty pricey. So all the components, like the rails, the pneumatics, the hoses, the valves, and all that stuff, all that by itself was over $650 US. And then the laser cut steel was almost $250 by itself. So literally just the components, not including the cost of actually putting it together, was nearly $1,000 US. If I had to guess, I'd say the whole shield probably cost around $2,000 to $3,000 once you consider the amount of time and labor that went into it with all the welding, the grinding. Powder coating a shield like this would cost quite a few hundred dollars because powder coating is only cheap when you're doing it in bulk. If you're doing a single job, that's a single setup. Luckily, my friend has a powder coating setup in his garage, so we were able to do it for free. So another question asked, are there gonna be more videos about the shield? And yes, there are. We've actually got two more videos still that are going to come out on the main channel. And that includes a Street Fighter style video where we destroy a car to the Street Fighter soundtrack with all the music and sound effects added, and it's gonna be great. And then we've got a really special video. It's actually going to be Captain America's old shield versus the new shield to see which one comes out on top. So quite a few people have asked if I'm going to release the designs to the public so you can try building your own. And to be honest, I haven't quite decided yet because I did put a lot of time and effort into this. And like I said, it costs over $1,000 to make, so I can't see too many people actually making this. But that being said, I might be releasing the designs to at least my Patreon followers. So is the shield really bulletproof? Well, nothing's actually bulletproof, but the shield is quite bullet resistant. Now, I did only test it with a 9mm, which is actually a pretty easy gun to make something bullet resistant. And I'm sure if we had a higher caliber weapon, we could actually punch through it. But like I was saying, the shield is actually really thick in the middle. It's almost an inch thick of steel. So it could actually stop quite a big round. But again, I don't really want to destroy this because it costs so much to make and took so long, and then it wouldn't work anymore. So we're not going to be doing any more tests to see how bulletproof it is. But I'm pretty happy that it can stop a 9mm. I think that's pretty convenient. So another question was asking, how much money do we spend on all the stuff we broke? And some people thought that it was actually more than the cost of making the shield, but that's just not true. The majority of the stuff that we break, we find in the garbage. On garbage day, we go out in the streets and we see what looks cool to break that people are already throwing out. So like that TV was already busted, the car we destroyed, well, we bought that, but it was only $100 because it was a parts car. It was missing almost everything it needed to be an actual car, and it wasn't worth repairing or fixing and making an actual street legal car. So we really don't spend that much money on breaking stuff. We always try and reuse garbage that looks cool to explode in slow motion. So what's my favorite? Captain America's original shield or the new one? Definitely the new one. The old one is iconic and it's a lot of fun, but I put so much more time and energy into making this one, and I personally think it's way better. Plus, we've got that video coming out, Captain America's old shield versus the new shield. Another question asked was, where did I get my awesome Captain America costume? You mean this one? We got this costume from Killer Body, and it's actually a licensed Captain America costume, although we did weather it a bit to make it look a bit more like the one in Infinity War. And to do that, we actually used Cosplay Chris's tutorial. There's links in the description below if you're interested in doing the same thing to your Captain America costume. We also did a photo shoot with new costume changes, including both our Wakandan shield build and Cap's original shield. So make sure you follow us on Instagram, where we'll be posting the final images and to get all the latest updates, as well as some teasers on upcoming projects at the Hacksmith. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed this project. It's gotta be one of my favorites. And if you have any more questions, leave them in the comments below.